Hello all. I'm Arita Raheja from first year BSc Biotechnology Modern College Ganesh Khind Pune. Projector 1, How to Culture Paramecium. Before we get started, here are a few facts about culturing paramecium. Paramecium can grow in fresh water. Use dechlorinated tap water or distilled water. Boiling is optional. If you do, let it cool down to room temperature. Fish food and snails are optional as well. P.S. I couldn't shoot a picture of my snails that I added in my sample. Let's get started. Procedure. I took green leafy vegetables, that is lettuce, and peeled it off. You can also take other leafy vegetables like spinach or kale, fresh or stale by a week. After peeling it off, I took dechlorinated tap water and boiled the lettuce with it. Let's call this sample number 1. Till the time it was boiling, I took my sample that I'd prepared a week before, which included past water change of my aquarium, soil, reed, wood, leaves that were fresh as well as wilted. Let's call this sample number 2. After the lettuce was boiled with tap water, I strained the sample 2 and added it to sample number 1. Next, I filled my containers, which included one plastic bottle and one glass jar, with a final sample. Next is waiting time, but before you keep it in the sun, make it a point that you leave some room for aeration. It's just to make sure that enough air is circulated. Now, shake the bottle and keep it open, or make a tiny hole on the plastic bottle cap, just like I did. There should be a bacterial bloom initially. After a week, the paramecium should show up, before which it does show a cloudy appearance. To keep the colony fresh, add a small amount of cat food, milk, or fish food. I chose to add fish food. Paramecium should spawn the dirt away. On the 8th day, I did get traces of these tiny structures, but it only lasted for 30 minutes. The growth depends upon the temperature and the amount of care taken during the experiment. So, this was my sample. Hope it helped you. Thank you for watching.